Thanks. Hello, everyone. Thanks to all for being here. Today, we are going to... we are on the second day of the online training program, Medinea On Air. Medinea On Air first session, which is supported by Medinea. It's co-founded by Erasmus Plus, and produced by six partners from the Mediterranean region from France, Italy, Malta, Portugal, Slovenia, and Turkey. Medinea On Air aims to provide specific preparation for classical musicians and improvisers to enrich young musicians' musical training with 38 live interactive webinars led by the known artists and high qualified pedagogues. They are free and open to all upon registration. Webinar preparing orchestra auditions brass instrument is about how to prepare orchestra excerpts at orchestra auditions for brass instruments. First, let me introduce myself. My name is Sayeli. I'm representative of Medinea On Air Pedagogical Committee at the Academy of Music, University of Ljubljana. I'm glad to welcome Professor who are going to give you tips and advices on how to be successful during auditions. So Professor Dušan.
Hello.
And Assistant Professor Jure. Hey. And Professor Boštjan.
Hello.
So webinar is going to last around 40-50 minutes. Each professor is going to comment on pre-recorded video which were made by students at the Academy of Music, University of Ljubljana. Professors picked orchestra excerpts from the compulsory orchestra excerpts for audition of Mediterranean Youth Orchestra. If you would like to get score, which will be played today, you can download from chat. Please feel free to write a question to chat address to me anytime during the webinar. It can be specific question for each instrument or general question about orchestra excerpts at auditions. So now we are starting with Dušan for trombone. So Matiz, please play the video.
So, hi everybody. Just in the start of my talking about orchestra excerpts, I would like to say thanks to Sayeli and Nina Podlipnik. Bravo for organization, staff of Music Academy. So in the start of preparing, learning and playing of orchestra excerpts, it's the most important thing of hearing the pieces. Hearing a complete piece, complete requiem, complete movement. So imagine the whole contents of story and harmonies and the technical particularities, because you are the part of big music story. The first orchestra excerpts is our solo Tubum Mirum, and we know Wolfgang Mozart, Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart's Requiem is one of the most important solos for the trombone in the orchestral literature, and appears on nearly every tenor trombone audition on the college or professional symphony orchestra. And we know all also Wolfgang did not live to finish the Requiem, and many people have stepped to in the put the piece in playable form. Mozart's wife asked Franz Süssmayr to finish the piece shortly after the composer's death. A look at Mozart manuscript shows us that he made very few markings to guide how the solo should be played. Our solo is the solo with the bass singer. So we play it with a singer, so we should singing with the trombone. That's very, very important. So cantabile e molto espressivo. So sadly we can go to the next. Yes, that was the Tony Sotoshek, student of mine. L'Enfant, le Sortilège is a fantasy lyric in deux parts, the child and the spells from Maurice Ravel. So again, most important thing to hearing the piece, hearing, listen the complete piece. Melody. Bel canto vocalizes, vocal virtuosity with the trombone. That is for me a point of departure here. Follow the articulation markings closely and sing out. This section is overmarked in the orchestra, so you will most likely need to be a strong singing mezzo forte to be heard clearly. In the uppermost register of the instrument, this solo should copy the portamento style of the singer. Again, air focus and molto cantabile con espressivo e con vibrato. It's allowed to make many vibrato in this in this excerpt. Say the next. The Schumann, Robert Schumann Rheinische Symphony for bass trombone, the symphony number 3. So where the trombone starts, it's the fourth movement. The fourth movement, the chatterer movement. It's very important to imagine what is the chatterer, feierlich solemn. It means to suggest a solemn ceremony. So the sound quality should be very feierlich, and should be a big chorale. So the trombone player should show the possibilities, his possibilities to play in chorale with the chamber music. So the sound quality, and again, air focus, much of air and much of sound control. This chorale is with the French horn, so it's very beautiful. It is writing for a notoriously difficult spot in performance science, the trombone. So for me, this is one of the beautiful pieces of the classical music for trombone.
Sorry, the next.
Yes, the Richard Wagner Tannhäuser. Tannhäuser und der Singkrieg of Wartburg. Again, very important to hear all the Tannhäuser, not just this overture, to understand the big thematic and the big message of this wonderful music. So the Tannhäuser ist Overture is Andante Maestoso, quarter ist 50. So please take the metronome. Take the metronome and practice with metronome, not just Wagner, Tannhäuser, everything, but for Tannhäuser is very important. Fortissimo with the marcato articulation. So good big sound, not aggressive, but very, very, very rich. Exactly intonation A major, not drag and not hurry, so practice with the metronome. So, Sai, that is my commentar to excerpts.
Thank you, Dušan. It was really, really interesting to hear what you're telling us. So now we are continuing with Jure for trumpet.
Hello, everybody. I'm also
Thank you.
just lost it. Hello? It's just
Hi,
no problem. It's just
no problem.
Or I haven't heard the clip till end. I don't know.
You couldn't hear the clip?
Till end.
Okay, I could hear it till the end.
Ah, okay.
Mm-hmm.
I listened to it anyway a few times before, so.
Okay.
I would also like to say hello to everybody. And also, I'm really happy to be here with you on this great project, and would like to say thanks to Sally and Nina Podlipnik for your great work that this is happening and for coordinating everything. So this first clip, which we heard, I hope you heard it till end, I haven't. It's a famous Bizet, Carmen Prelude from opera. And here we have the opportunity to show really like this lyrical character of the trumpet. Already on the beginning, we are playing together with a section of cellos. And this requires nice, warm sound. I think this is what should be taken care of in already daily routine with the exercises like Chikovit, Stem, Damrau, Bel Canto. So this is, I think, really important to do on daily basis. This clip is interesting because of the note F natural, which we are not having. And so as Blas did also, I use B flat trumpet with extended third valve. I think he did a great job. And my two biggest comments would be like to take care of ending the phrases to kind of let the sound flow, stay open, really breathe in the rhythm. And of course, exaggerate with the dynamic also. Staying together with the cellos is always to find the good color of the sound. This is the main idea, I think. I would use this kind of dynamic signs like crescendos and decrescendos also for supporting musical idea. So in this case, like always go against long note. So it's called this, the long note, and then do nice decrescendo on this. And maybe also like think about dynamic scales in your daily routine. This would be my tip for Blas, and I said to him this already, and try to develop it like every day to go more and more out of your box. This would be my first comment on first clip, and I suggest that we go to second clip. This is a famous ballerina dance from Stravinsky's Petrushka. For sure, this is the most requested trumpet audition piece. And it's really important to keep all of these details which we need for this piece, as I said before, on daily basis to practice them. So don't forget that ballerinas are graceful, are light, and this light crispy articulation for sure help us to show the right character of the piece which is required. I think Miloro did a great job. I would also suggest him to try to play this maybe in one or in two breaths, so don't breathe too often, because then with this he got a bit of high center of the sound through whole excerpt. So I would keep it like keep the low center of the sound. And of course, take care of good attacks here, really, like, especially when we are starting to slur on from this, like, tara, 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 tari, tim, tam, tiram, to really like, have a good support on the first note that we can then slur on for the passage which is coming. And for this is, we are trying to do a lot of urban exercises where this in every chapter is kind of this mentioned. So I think the crispy, good articulation with the, of course, good sound is the point to have the good character of the ballerina's dance in Stravinsky. As I said, depends then when you're playing with the conductor, if it's possible, it's good to try it in one breath. And for this, we are practicing like in different ways to have read marks, sure where it's coming, and practice all kinds of the situations through. These are my short comments on these two short clips.
Thank you, Jure. It was really interesting, yes. So now we are moving on to with Boštjan for Holland.
Yep, so I'm unmuted.
Yep.
Hello.
So, hi, we are starting now the video. Is it fine?
Very good. Just say hi and pleasure to be with you. I'm back. That was Anna, student of mine, not only very good horn player, not only very good low horn player, but I would say universal horn player. We, as you all know, or you might know, we divide for the low horn and the high horn, similar as the trombones. We had one bass trombone and one tenor trombone, but we use the same instrument, but we have different ranges, which in a German space, it's quite strict, and you usually don't jump from high to low, and you are somehow you have direction to be only low horn player or only high horn player. But more or less nowadays, you have to be universal, and of course you can be bloody good low horn player, but still does not mean that you play only low and the opposite as well. So it's good to mix it, and no need to be as strong in the high or as strong in the low. But my theory, or we try to do it, that you have the general range. So Anna has been playing all the general repertoire, like Strauss 1 or Mozart 4, preparing for the high horn auditions. But this time she picked up a real low horn. This was Don Quixote by Richard Strauss. And about this excerpt, is more or less very important, good, healthy, solid sound, which does not need to be overblown. One more little detail. We always think that the good low horn players are loud horn players. Not true. Listening and playing really subtle, the low register or the middle register is a very difficult thing, which needs to be cared. To take care about it, and actually at the end of the audition, those are the spots if you just nail it or if you do play a music. And to do play a music, it does mean that you are singing through the instrument and never full and never flat, of course. So the fact is that I think Anna was playing pretty good sound, and another trap is to swallow, to eat up or eat down, to swallow down the bits, which if there is only one beat in between the pause or two beats, it's not so dangerous, but very dangerous where we go one, two, 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 and ta di 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 di, because it's a very long bar phrase. And another thing, it's two against three. So the general move and general rhythm is da 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 di da da di, and then we come in with the eighth note, with a crotchet. So with this means that we go to play two against three, and ta 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 di do da dam pam pam ta di do da dam. And very dangerous is that this upbeat or this crotchet, this quaver is playing like a triplet, and then big, healthy singing. Legato, it's all about arpeggi, so we usually do every day our warm-up exercises with the arpeggi, use it here, and think about long phrase, played forte if it requires forte, but do not overblow it and think the way you have to go through, and keep it round, keep it lovely, and singing only forte and two against three. I think this is in a short everything, and do not forget about the good sound. Not only to be in tune, not only to be rhythmically, but playing good sound. I think we can go on.
Boštjan, you have to unmute.
Good. Thank you for warning me. Mm-hmm. This was Mahler 9, beautiful playing by Anna again. It's quite a coincidence. I'm sitting in the middle of Klagenfurt, which is Carinthia, Austria, Österreich. And Mahler spent quite some time here having vacations on Osiachase and so on. So I feel very familiar with this music at the moment. So get to the piece. The piece is the last symphony by Gustav Mahler, and we all know he wasn't happy. He was not a happy man. He was not a happy boy, and his last stage of his life was not the happy either. So it's very deep and lots of tragic and lots of really dark thinking and dark feeling in. And this is on the beginning. We have, I think, two bars, like really low floating double basses and celli. And then the second horn comes in with a boucher, with a gestopf. And this is, of course, important to keep the sound with boucher, not to lose the articulation, not to lose the intonation, which is at least as double difficult to doing boucher, good sound and good intonation, as with a normal singing playing. And then we go with a big phrase, legato, the sixth. I think the sixth, oh, is the optimist. It's the optimist way. It's all the Volkslieder here in Carinthia and in Slovenia are mostly the third or the sixth. And the sixth is the most optimistic and singing, bringing life. And so to combine with the Mahler 9, which is actually calling the end, which is the last note, dying out, dying, vanishing. It's the sixth, is the positive way. It's the going for life. But I think, actually, I'm taking this from some stories by a great conductors, which I worked with, is that if when you're going to die and when you're leaving this world, you start watching back. And this is kind of reminiscence to your youth and to your past, which it was hopefully happy and lucky. So all those, it's kind of bringing reminiscence into the positive and young stage and the happy life. And as you see, this sixth is going then down. We're already lower. And even more, so it's like an old man or an old person. It's still alive and remembering the beautiful things in a life, but going lower and lower with the energy, still coming a bit up, still optimism. Not every day is bad day, even in the last stage of your life. And then you go down, down, and the last note is a farewell from this world. And if we take it this way, then it's nonsense to talk it about the rhythmus, about the intonation, and about the sound. If we take it this way, the sound will be there if we are not emotionally crippled, and the sound will be there, emotion will be there, and I'm nobody to say that the original idea, who knows what the original idea of Mahler was it. But if we do connect with the spirit of Mahler in such a way, then any try to do it is welcome. Then we open our heart, we open our soul, and we do the story. We do our singing, our emotional way to connect with the Mahler's emotional way. And in any case, it's much better than playing the notes and playing only the rhythm and only the sound and only the intonation. But if we play only the rhythm and only intonation and only being correct, the story, the emotional side is never there. But if we play emotional side, then the rhythm and the sound and being correct is always there. That's about this one. Here we go, Stravinsky, Le Sacre du Printemps. Not a typical auditioning piece, and very difficult to catch the atmosphere, which is in this and huge orchestra, huge orchestration, is with a good conductor and with a solid orchestra, not so difficult to catch the atmosphere. But to play this part, this passage all alone, it's extremely difficult. So I would say that the first one, try to reflect kind of Slavic folks tune. A bit silly and completely free, just like some peasants dancing on the field or something. So try to be spontaneously, not too soft, not too loud, but very light and very lovely with a good singing legato. But it's not the way of Brahms legato or Mahler legato or what we have been talking about, Strauss legato, which we've been talking before. And then the last one, the middle part, again, very difficult. It's not a solo at all. Very difficult to catch the audition. So what you can show is you can show if this would be the part of the audition, which is very not often happening. So it's to show the solid sound, solid legato, and extremely being calm. So like, take your time, like singing, low singing. And the last one, again, I would say that Sebastian was playing maybe a bit too marcato or too maybe a bit more too punchy legato. I would go for sorry for my singing. So, but it's not one horn, as you know, then half of the group at least is playing this part. So important not to force and to get a good group sound, which it means four times solid round sound is much more powerful than one pinchy overforced sound, not even to say if we have four players which they are forcing on their own. So being part of mixed sound and the ensemble bringing good stuff here, which is extremely difficult to show. So what we can show at the audition, if we have this piece, is like to be correct and to try to play solid sound with the situation that we know we are not the soloists here, but we are part of the group, so that we show 1/4 of the sound which is coming when we are taking place in the orchestra. Thank you. We go on. Good. Sorry, I'm a bit sloppy with mute and unmute. Thank you. Thank you for helping me. So this was Brahms' second, and another coincidence. This is Kärnten, Carinthia, Klagenfurt, and not far away from here, the Brahms composed this second symphony. And the funny thing or interesting thing is that he was using lots of naive folk tunes in all his symphonies, but in number second especially. And those folk songs are not Austrian, are not Slovenian, but are Kärnten, Carinthia. And Carinthia is part in Austria, part in Slovenia. So we do feel very familiar with this. The beginning needs to be very plain and very not over complex, but still solid. Good sound from the tummy, supported, but not heavy. So light and transparently, and as simple as possible, but of course, good singing. And here we are again, the third and the sixth, again. And here I would say is bringing the spring, bringing the happiness, and bringing the all the positive thing, two horns, third, sixth. And if we have 10 seconds for a joke, they say this is the only symphony starting with the trill in double basses. And then we go on. And the big horn solo at the end of the first movement was well played by Sebastian. Difficult is to keep the good and the rich sound because it's a really long way to go, and we have to control the breath. We have to control the airflow and stay tuned down, so that we don't get closed, and this kind of F sharp at the end, F sharp in horn, I'm telling, so the sounding B natural, is getting sharp if so. So to keep it down, to singing down, and to dosieren ist auf Deutsch, so to keep in balance, to balance it very good, to build up very good crescendo, not too soon, not too much, and playing very, very good balance between the vertical and horizontal. Because the Brahms, my opinion, is that the too much vertical, boring, too much horizontal, a mess. And we could go away in another stuff with lots of vertical in Beethoven, for instance. If we have like six bars to play second horn, third, first horn in a Beethoven, and we play very vertical and very rhythmically, not much to lose. But if we play only vertical and only rhythmically in Brahms, much to lose. So we have to go singing plus being somehow logically in time and shaping, and do not forget about the waving. And it's a big solo, but usually not such a big as we think. And if we take it not too big, then we do a gradually crescendo in a good way, and we do not open too soon, and we do a big, big, big climax, which is asked here, and then opening again at the end of the horn solo. So that was it from me. And I would like to thank Nina and Sally also. And very nice to spend these few minutes with all of you here on net. Hope to collaborate again. And thank you for giving us trust and chance, and to giving our students trust and chance to represent those little things, which hopefully will grow into a bigger things. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Boštjan. Okay, we are really on the time. Okay, we are a little bit behind time, but I would like to ask you three one question. Do you find it important for a young musician to participate in orchestra academy or youth orchestra before starting with audition? So maybe Dušan, you can start with the.
Yes, of course. Any activity of this kind is very, very important. To have a own system how to go to youth orchestra or make a audition. But what I can say is, of course, take any chance to make audition in your class, to make audition in your before your friends, and make training to prepare to this final audition where you can be then Berlin Philharmonic or I don't know.
Yes, I absolutely agree with you. To have really experience in the stage, yes, in front of someone, it's really important. Yes,
exactly.
Yes. How about Jure?
Yes, as brass players, I think it's a privilege to play with somebody else also. So it's like normally when the students are studying their parts and their lines, it's one thing, but then coming in the group and play together with colleagues, this adds, as also already before said Boštjan, like to play in four together, in three together with a good sound to balance these things and to experience this before you go into the auditions, I think it's a really important thing. I find it in, we have kind of good tradition here to play in the, or in brass bands or in the bands before, and that already music schools are having the orchestra, so they are having, the pupils are having chance to play and to have this experience. And I find that this is really important for us, especially for brass players, to play in group, to create this family feeling, and then to realize what is your role in the group to play. So because we are, it's not always the same. Sometimes you need to lead, sometimes you need to adjust, and as soon as you get this, better it is, I think, on your professional way than for the.
Of course, yes, I totally agree with you. And Boštjan, how do you think?
Yeah, well, grab any chance to play chamber music and orchestra, any kind of orchestra, because this is fun. Doing the auditions is not fun, and preparing for auditions is not fun. What we have to do it, and the fun is coming afterwards when we nail it. So the thing is, if we had no chance to play in youth orchestra, in the youth wind band, in the school orchestra, in any kind of orchestra, we would know how fun it is. So if we would say you are not allowed to play in any kind of orchestra, but first practice for audition and be bloody perfect, then everyone would jump away from our part of business. So I would say grab any situation to play lots of chamber music, always to play together, always even to practice together, and take any occasion to play youth orchestras, and even take occasion to play funeral and wedding music, just to being part of the different emotional stuff. And every experience is very, very, very important.
Yeah, exactly. Thank you, Boštjan. So thank you, Dušan, Jure, and Boštjan, for sharing your knowledge and thoughts with us today. By the end of this week, you will get a link to access the replay of this webinar during 3 weeks. We are continuing tomorrow with a webinar making a proper video applications for classical and Medinea auditions at 2 o'clock UTC time, and connecting with your audiences at 3 o'clock UTC time. You're all welcome to attend. The second session is scheduled in December 2022. Please follow Medinea on social networks to know when you can subscribe. So this concludes the webinar. Thank you all for attending. We hope you have learned and enjoyed in this webinar. Thank you.
Thank you.
Goodbye.
Thank you. Bye.
Goodbye.
Bye-bye.
Bye, everybody.
Bye-bye.
Bye.